Great. Welcome to my presentation about paid membership systems. I'm Sander Potje. I'm a co-founder of JoomlaCommunity.eu. That's a Dutch community, active in the Netherlands and Belgium mostly. Also organizer of the Joomla Days in the Netherlands, so you're all invited next year. Organizer of the Joomla user groups. We have currently about 14 in our small country, and most of them are meeting each month, so we have a quite active community. I recently joined the Joomla CLT community leadership team, and I have my own company with some Joomla web development mostly, and I'm still studying architecture, so that's a bit of my background. But you're not here for me, but for the paid membership systems or subscription systems. We have several options for that. We can use Joomla extensions, but we also see that many are using non-Joomla solutions. What are some possible Joomla solutions? Maybe you've used one of them before. There are several others. Not all are listed in the Joomla extension directory, I found out, but these are some that are listed on this URL. I will post the slides on SlideShare later on, so you don't need to write anything down. You can download it and use it for your own use. Some possible non-Joomla solutions. Maybe if you've seen one of these names before when you're buying a membership from several other Joomla companies. And how to choose between a Joomla or a non-Joomla solution? Some advantages of Joomla, non-Joomla solutions. Non-Joomla solutions are really easy to set up. You just sign up, enter your email, your contact details, and you add your product and you can start using it. Also, many payment providers or other payment solutions are integrated. You don't need to set up those specific. They're all available, and they're mostly a big list of those available extensions. What we see also is that many offer a multilingual sign-up page. So if your customer is from Germany, he gets a German sign-up page. Is he from the Netherlands? A Dutch page. So that's really increasing the conversion in most cases. They did a lot of research for that. And you can also offer to pay in your local currency. In the United States, you pay in dollars. In Europe, you pay euros and any other currency. Those not Joomla extensions are really focused on conversion. They always try to improve it. And there are many possibilities to increase your sales, also cross-selling. If somebody buy a product, they get suggestions for other products as well. And we also see that they have really advanced reporting. I don't think there's at the moment a Joomla extension with that advanced reporting as offered in most of those web-based solutions. But why would you choose for Joomla solutions? With non-Joomla solutions, all data is stored on external servers. With information about credit card, that's fine. You don't want that on your own server, but also the sign-up details, the address, when did the membership started, it's all stored on an external database. Also, if you use a Joomla extension, all code is under your control. You can see every line of the code, and if needed, you can change it or extend it. Also, when you're using a non-Joomla solution, you always need to have a kind of API or XML connection to your own a website to allow people to download something or access the forum. That depends on your situation. But you always need to find if there is already a connection in some cases, and in others there's not, so you need to route your own connection between the external and your Joomla website. If you're using a Joomla website with a Joomla extension, that is not needed. Also, the price, the fee you pay per sale is in most cases lower than when you're using your own website with, for example, PayPal. You can imagine if you use external service, they want some of your selling for them themselves. And that depends on the solution. Some you need to pay a basic fee for each month use, some for each transaction. So that really depends. In this presentation, I really focus on the Joomla extension itself. I will only discuss how to choose your the right membership extension for Joomla. We already saw there are many Joomla extensions in the community. And as always, help, which one do I need to choose? It's difficult. I will not tell you the best extension, but I will give you some guides to choose your extension for your situation. So how do you select the membership extension for your project? One of the things where you could take care of it is which version are you using for Joomla? Do you have already a version in mind, or do that depends on the possibilities of the extension? At the moment, most 1.0 is already end of life, so most extensions are available for 1.5 or 1.7. Both versions have an end of life date next year, early next year. 1.5 will reach end of life state April 2012, and Joomla 1.7 February 2012. And you might think, why is 1.7 earlier than end of life than 1.5? That's because of the new release strategy. You will possibly need to upgrade anyway to Joomla 2.5. You all know already that the next version will not be 1.8, but 2.5, meanwhile. Okay. Joomla 2.5, not a big difference than 1.7, will be released on January 2012. So a month after that, Joomla 1.7 will reach end of life. Joomla 2.5 itself will reach end of life in November 2013. So that's still a few months in the future, so we can really use that. If you now choose for Joomla 1.5, you will need to upgrade in early 2012 to 2.5. And the migration between 1.5 and 2.5 is a lot tougher than the migration from 1.7 to 2.5. The migration between 1.7 and 2.5 will be similar like the 1.6 to 1.7 migration. So we were able to migrate our website from the backend of our Joomla website. So if possible, I would suggest to choose for 1.7, use all new features in it, and your upgrade process will be a lot smoother. So that's my suggestion. If possible, choose for 1.7. I've also, if you want to know more about this release strategy, I created an infographic, also a German one, translated by David. So don't know if he's here. Thank you. You can download it on this website URL, where you can see all information about when is something reached end of life, and how's the version numbering working, and what is long-term release, what is short-term release. So have a look, you can download it, print it, or do whatever you want, distribute it on your local, on your blog, so people start understanding the new release system. Another important thing for your selection of your right membership extension is the functionality. What do you want with your membership? Do you want multiple subscription levels? Do you want a subscription renewal? Do you want to offer upgrades between different subscriptions? So you have already a subscription, but you want to upgrade to a higher level. Do you want to offer coupon or discounts? Do you want to offer invoicing with PDF invoicing or just simple HTML page? Do you want any advanced reporting? And all these functionalities really depend between those extensions available. Some don't even have invoicing. Some don't have coupon support. So write down all your requirements for your membership. It's really important to have that clear in mind. What do you want? You can always have some, maybe you didn't thought before about upgrade between subscription levels, and you think, that's a nice idea, I can use that. So you can always browse those websites, see what features they have, and if that features are good for you. Another important point to select your extension is the payment methods. Not all extension membership extensions offer all payment solutions. Most support iDo of a PayPal out of the box. Some offer some credit card support. But for example, in the Netherlands, we have a very popular local payment solution that's called iDo, and the Dutch users really want to use iDo to buy the products. So look at your target of your subscription, who needs to buy your products, what are they used to payment methods, and select an extension that's supporting those payment methods, or in some cases they offer a really flexible support to extend a payment provider with it. Some are really using those payment providers hard-coded in their extension, and some are using it via plugin system. So you can easily install another plugin to offer another payment solution. So some payment methods: PayPal, credit card, WorldPay, CC Avenue. Look at your local payment provider. Another very important thing is the connectivity. Membership is one thing. You sell something, but what will the user be able to do after they buy your subscription? Do you want to offer downloads or access to a forum? Do you want to give access to specific content? Do you want to access photos? Do you want to give some support? Or anything else you can imagine. That really depends on your situation. But look at what you're willing to offer and what is possible for those extensions. This is a very tricky part, because if you have multiple, like for example, downloads, you want to have some support, and a forum, so ticketing and forum, you need to find three extensions. They are all able to connect with your membership extension. So if somebody subscribes, he automatically get access to the forum, to the right forums, or to the right downloads. And if they upgrade to a new level, they get more access. So those extensions need to talk to each other. And that's very difficult, because you have your membership extension, that's already a big challenge to find the right one, but also the challenge to find extensions that are working with your membership extension. So write down all needed functionality, very clear. I would suggest to start searching for extensions after you have a kind of overview of what possible membership extensions are fitting my requirements, and then look to the possible extension. Most of the membership extensions have a list on the website with some supported popular extension, like download component, forum component. Most of them support one or more. So find out if there is a real good connection and can you use it. Another very important part is tax. We're all here in Europe, and if you're a European business, you need to calculate the tax on your sales. And that's quite difficult in the European Union. If you are a registered business with a valid VAT number, if you sell something to someone outside the European Union, you don't are allowed to calculate tax for it. So they don't need to pay any tax. Inside the European Union, if a customer pays the tax, they need to pay that for their local authorities. So they won't pay VAT either. If they're inside the European Union and they're no business, they pay VAT. And a customer from your own country, for your customer in Germany, or is it business or personal, they pay VAT anyway. Thea?
Visitors from inside the EU with a company and a valid VAT number, you should do note on the invoice that you are attributing the VAT to the other country.
Yeah.
It's now no VAT, it's VAT transfer.
Yeah. You transfer the VAT, and that's indeed also directly important that you are kind of offering an invoice solution for your extension. And when I was searching for solutions that were capable to do that, I only found one. Most extensions have simply one rule. That's pay a fixed VAT on sales. So for example, 20% of your sales is tax, no matter where they come from. So that's very important to find out how are you going to run your business, and does the extension support this kind of complicated rules? Another important thing, or maybe less important, is the design. Some extensions look beautiful from the front end. The subscription page looks awesome, great layout, great style, but the code below isn't that good. So it's nice if the extension is looking good, but if the extension isn't looking good, maybe it's the best solution for you anyway, because it's not too difficult to change it. You can easily change your page for you can easily override the template of it. If you know template overrides, you know that you can easily put the layout in your template folder, start changing it, add some CSS to it, and you can style it your own way. It's just the output, so the output is not really important for selecting your extension. You can always have a good designer for it and change it in the way you want. Also look at the code. I noticed that some extensions out there are using are running on Joomla 1.7, but if you really look at the code, it looks like Mumbo. It's really old style coding. They just ported it to 1.7 that it's running, it's installing, but you still have to Mumbo interface kind of behind it. Have a look if you can find an extension that has a clean MVC extension model, so you can easily override it with a template override. Just try to find if you can download it, have a look at the code, and make sure you have a good extension. Also, because a membership extension, you don't want that any information is kind of below C-less stored on another data server. So check your extension carefully. I would told before, MVC extensions are a really big plus. You can easily override it, change it to your needs. Another important thing is the project itself. What about the extension project? When was the last update? On what version is it running? Is there, who's the developer behind it? Do we know the developer before from other extensions? Do they have success with it? How is the extension support? Is there any support? Is there any documentation available? Or do you need to find out everything yourself? Is the extension still in development, or is it really finished and almost dead, the project? It's interesting if an extension keeps updating, and not every day, that's too much work, but if sometimes some new features are added, you know that the project is still alive. Is there any roadmap? Are there some features you're missing at the moment, but will they add it in the future? And another thing, what I think is very important, are feedback and suggestions welcome. If you have a suggestion or feedback, or something is not really your need at the moment, but you can say to the developer, this is my problem, is he willing to listen to it? Are they willing to implement your feature in the future? Those are really important things to have a clear look on it. So, the best extension, that really depends on your project. It's one big puzzle you need to solve. With all these kind of requirements, you need to find out what is the best fitting for my project, what is what I'm going to do, and what is the best case for this. I recently, you saw it a few hours before, ACL manager for Joomla, and that's why I'm trying to find out this subscription system. For the ACL manager, I wanted a Joomla 1.7 website. That was a must. I mean, ACL is for 1.7, so if I use a 1.5 site, was possible, but I like to have the 1.7 already. Invoicing was important because of the what Theo just told to transfer the VAT to the customer. Also the VAT handling. If a customer from outside the European, he don't pay any VAT. So that was important for me as well, because I'm based in the Netherlands, have a valid business number. PayPal, an ideal payment methods. I want PayPal and I want IDEAL because my Dutch market is also quite big and the Dutch are used to use PayPal, of IDEAL, sorry. Other thing, downloads. At the end, you buy a subscription to download the ACL manager. And for the support, I wanted the ticket system. So these are the kind of, sure, there were some models, but the most important things for me when I start looking for a suitable extension. At the end, I found out that Akiba subscription was the best extension for this case. It offered those tax rules, and in total there are about 20 rules I need to add in Akiba subscription to get it done, but it's working fine. I'm running on 1.7. Nicholas is known in the Joomla community, the same guy of Akiba Backup, was really open to listen to my feedback, and that was really working very well. For the tickets, I'm using RS Tickets. We know that that company as well. Akiba offered a solution that if somebody has a subscription, they automatically be added to a Joomla 1.7 user group. And in Akiba, you can grant access to a specific Joomla user group to send in the tickets. For the downloads, I'm using Docman, a good oldie. Used it many times before. I knew it's also kind of secured. People can't download the copy the download link directly and share it with others so they can download it from your server. It's always kind of encrypted. Akiba backup, for Akiba subscription is by default looking this way. And when I first saw it, I wasn't really enthusiastic about this. I have something else in mind. For example, ARIS memberships, it was looking really good directly, but don't offer any VAT handling. I changed it to this. This is my sign-up page, just by template overrides, adding some extra CSS styles, what was able to change it. And what I really like, if you're on a page that as soon as you start filling in or adding a discount, the price automatically be updated, so directly visible. Also, if you say I'm a business, the VAT is displayed, yes or no. So that's working really well. Normally, with a Akiba subscription, if you log in, this is the screen of your subscription. I changed it a bit, and this is the screen if you log in on the ACL manager. Added some new buttons, for example, the invoice. I will come in a few slides to that. And just styling. The details of your subscription were in Akiba, just simply this list, kind of table. No tables on my site, I don't want a table, and it isn't looking that nice. So I changed it to this page. And this is the detail of your subscription. And also the downloads are available on the same page. And this is Docman, but this is also a Akiba on one page. I changed the template, added some module support to it, so I could load a Docman, simple module with a lister, so display the downloads on the page as well. And because Akiba subscription is using the Nuku framework, it's really easy to use data from other tables. Nicholas is not display any user details, etc. But because of the Nuku framework, I was easily to call those data just in my page and just override it. And I was also able to duplicate this view to an invoice view. And that invoice view is nothing less more than a simple HTML page with the invoice on it and it start printing. So Akiba subscription didn't have any invoice before, but simply duplicated and I have the invoice solution as well. In the backend, Akiba subscriptions has a great overview of your sales. You see how much subscription you sold and how much you earned. The green is the amount, the total amount of subscription, and the blue line is the amount you earned. You can add some multiple levels. I just have one level, the ACL manager, so I'm not really using it. And the overview of the subscription, you see a name. He is even using Gravatar. You can turn that off so you don't see all the faces of your customers because it's loading that from Gravatar. And another nice feature is the discount coupons. So you can set a discount for an amount of money or a discount percentage. And you can have many rules as you want. Another nice feature is that you can add upgrades. So if you have a kind of current subscription and you want a bigger subscription, you can upgrade those subscription and you get a discount on it. Also, if you, for example, renew your current subscription before the end of the expiration date, you get a discount as well. And these are the tax calculations. This is the Greece example. So you see all those rules are at the end working to have those tax handling on the right way on your website. So for me, this was the best solution to use Akiba subscription with Docman and Aeris tickets, and mostly because I was able to add those users if you sign up to a specific user group, what is now able to define what they're able to do in 1.7. And the extension I'm using are able to give access to specific user groups. So thank you. I will post my slides to SlideShare this afternoon so you can download it and use it. And are there any questions left? And if you want to ask me a question afterwards about your specific situation, what is suitable for you, for your extension, you're always happy to come. So thank you. Okay, no questions, I think. Oh, one. Yeah, Joomla is the CMS, and you don't offer download support. So in my case, for example, I installed Docman, and Docman is an extension to offer downloads and manage them, and say and give access to specific user groups.
So Joomla for you is only the building itself, and the rest is only
all extensions, as we called it in Joomla. Yeah. So the membership is an extension, the downloads is an extension, the support is an extension. And that, in total, makes my Joomla site.
With other words, you don't use any groups or users or something from Joomla itself?
When somebody sign up on this page, they get assigned to a Joomla user group. And that's part of the Joomla core itself.
Yeah. But it's not a part of your membership payment subscription?
Now, the membership system is mostly handling that somebody completed your order, that they again get assigned to the Joomla user group. So they don't offer their own group support. No, that's handled by Joomla. The subscription is only transferring the user to the correct group. Yeah. Yeah, it's not even synchronized because there are no group support in Akiba.
How can I combine Akiba subscription with Sobi entries?
That depends if Akiba already offer Sobi entries and support. Akiba is a kind of flexible structure with plugins he's offering connections to other extensions. So in some cases, the extension, for example, Sobi, offered a kind of plugin for Akiba, so you can connect those. And in some cases, Nicholas already developed a connection between those two. I don't know if it's already available, but if not available, you can always ask, are there any plans for it, and see what's possible. To get an overview of the features of those extensions.
Yeah,
that's the problem is there is at the moment a real overview by the extension directory of all features. So if somebody makes those overview, it is available. But at the end, it turned out you need to find out yourself. And also because all extensions are kind of offering their kind of own version of a feature. So that's really a difficult part of finding an extension to find out what are the features and what is the difference between extension X and extension I. So that's really difficult. Yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry. I downloaded and paid for about 6, because most membership extensions are not for free. Akiba is in case, but it was not important for me because I paid for 5 other extensions to try out. And just to have a good overview about the real features. For me, it's most times easier just to simply install it and clicking through it so I get an overview of features than going through all pages and find out what the features are of those specific extensions. But there are several other nice extensions out there as well. But yet, one of the most important things, the text support was only available in Akiba. So that was a kind of easy one for me to decide to go for Akiba at the end. That you can see the membership sign-up page is a kind of registration form for Joomla. But you will only be added to the specific group if you complete your order. And you store some more data, but it's using for the name and the email and the username. It's simply using the Joomla core system of users.
And the user status will be set back when the year has expired or whatever?
Yeah. And that depends on the extension. But in the case of Akiba, there's a plugin that is looking at the end of your subscription and then can transfer it back to another user group. So past members, for example. And it's also possible that he sends out a reminder that your subscription is going to expire 30 days before and again a week before. So those are some additional plugins to offer those features. Yeah, I would like to offer some support to my clients. So that's why, and I'm not using a forum, but the ticket system. And if you're not a member, you can submit a ticket already, but only to the pre-sales category. And if you become a member, you can add some other question and you get support. So that's the reason why I added the ticket system. And you can choose between forum and ticketing. Some like the forum, some like the ticketing. In my case, I like the ticketing, so that's the reason. Okay, thank you. Enjoy the rest of the last few hours.